Good afternoon, everyone. Thank you very much and a very warm welcome to all the participants attending this webinar today. Thank you for taking your time to spend time with us to know more about CyberSight's offering. My name is Murali Velat and I'm the division head for the Corporate Security Division of Bulwark. And I'm really excited to introduce to you our new entrant in the NAC, DNS and phishing space. The company we're showcasing today is CyberSight. In fact, although they're a late entrant, they've come with a bang in terms of being able to garner a very large deal with an oil and gas company last year, and the implementation is going on now. So it's very exciting considering the fact that they've actually competed against some of the big guys in the NAC and DNS space. So therefore, joining me is my co-host for the session, Nekati Ertuğrul, who is the founder and the chief technical officer of CyberSight. Yeah. So the agenda for today would involve just an overview of the company, followed by the solution stack from CyberSight. So he will be providing, Nekati would be providing you with a demo of the solution. And we will have a Q&A session towards the end of the session. So we will also have a Q&A chat window, so you can post whatever you have, any queries that can be addressed at the moment in time. So a bit about Bulwark. So we are a value-added distributor in the region, the Middle East region, for the last 20 plus years. We started in 1999. We've been very successful in that we have been always a pure play distribution company where we have involved a very good channel team to be able to translate those products across so the solutions that we've actually acquired over the years. We've been very successful. We are a privately held organization and we've been profitable right from the first year onwards. We are very well represented in different arenas of the information security for the region. We've got more than 22 vendors in the space. When we acquired these vendors, were cutting edge vendors. These were vendors who had a complete value add over a lot of other solutions in the market. And with their product portfolio, we've been very successful in the region. So we have been operating in the GCC countries, North Africa, and we have our presence in India as well. As I mentioned earlier, we have a very strong partner community, over 500 plus across the region. We work very closely with all our partners. We have a very strong team of dedicated sales force who actually help these partners with their business to take a win-win approach in mind. And we also have a dedicated marketing and technical team. The way we've handled these products is to provide the utmost certification for our technical team so that they can provide the best of services to our customers and our partners. We also have good certified technical engineers for CyberSight, and we are good to go on the technology. With that, I would hand this over to Nekati to provide you with the rest of the session on the solution in terms of what the whole thing is all about, the CyberSight offering, and provide you with a demo of their NAC DNS and phishing space. Yeah. Over to you, Nekati.
Thank you very much, and thanks for your time today. So let me continue with the presentation. I think everyone can see it, I hope, without a problem. So this is just some highlights from CyberSight. We are a UK-based company founded by industry veterans, having a very strong DNS security infrastructure where we have a threat intelligence for more than 2.4 billion domain assets. Currently, there are more than 900 plus customers in more than 67 countries. Of these, currently we have large scale deployments in UK, UAE, United Arab Emirates, Turkey and Russia. Majority of the customers are government, international banks, international manufacturing companies, and education institutes. The products have been developed for more than 15 years with a very strong development team, and they were the chosen technologies in international banks with more than 1,000 branches very important major government organizations, banks in Russia. So there has been a very strong span area. And very recently in Dubai, we have been the chosen technology in a leading oil and gas company. So what are the current challenges? As you all know, very recently, there has been breaches in Honda and Enel. And that these breaches show us how malicious applications still can spread easily. Since the networks are very, very weak, there are always points, there are always systems which are misconfigured or not up to date, which you have seen in Honda and Enel. And it is very difficult to increase the awareness level of all of our users, right? So there is someone who is always not careful. And I always say, you know, a chain is only as strong as the weakest link. So a mistake of one employee creates chain reactions, which can result in a breach. So cybersecurity, protecting our assets, really requires a lot of, planning and alignment on different fronts. Today, I will be going to the details of the products. Very shortly, I will discuss how we can support increased remote working, because our solutions are a very good fit for fulfilling the certain requirements for the remote workforce. There will be three products that I will be mentioning on product level, and I will briefly discuss CloudSight, which is our managed security as a service platform, which will be available from this July. So it will be a complete Kubernetes-based, Docker-based infrastructure where our customers, partners, distributors, MSSPs, everyone can utilize with an increased level of brand recognition, which I will come to its details. So we have been consolidating our product solutions in our CloudSight platform. So what are the products? DevSight is our first product. DevSight is a GDPR compliant email phishing detection and email inbox security solution. With remote working, of course, this has become very important as more and more attacks are starting with phishing attacks as the user is remote. It is easier to exploit the user now. DNSSight is our core technology, which is a recursive DNS service, which enables us to discover and block any malicious traffic going to the internet from the endpoints without deploying agents. NetSight is our next solution, a network access control solution, which is agentless and very easy to deploy and scale. Lastly, I will discuss IDSight, which is our on-premise MFA platform, which we are currently in the process of migrating to our cloud infrastructure, was currently on-premise, but it's a great enabler if you are looking for an on-premise MFA solution. So let's start with CloudSight. CloudSight is a multi-tenant SaaS platform for protecting users, networks, and applications 24/7. Currently, it has the two main modules, the DNSSight, which is our DNS security, and our email inbox security solution. Why initially we have these two in CloudSight? Because there are two points that the end user interferes with, interferes for communication, right? One is accessing websites, applications, so it is internet access. And the other is the email. So by covering these two, we are able to offer 360 degrees security for end users in a very, very lightweight platform. CloudSight can be deployed on any cloud platform, Amazon AWS, Google Cloud, Microsoft Azure. Any platform supporting Kubernetes can be used, and MSSP can utilize the platform offered by us under their brand, or they can deploy so they have their control. So what are the important features of CloudSight? It's an integrated platform with an unprecedented level of simplicity, scalability, and threat discovery. So the biggest catch is it's very, very easy to deploy. In fact, even to organizations with tens of thousands of users, it is deployed in minutes, maybe hours. It's very lightweight. All components are deployed centrally, providing very strong level of visibility. It provides complete protection by securing internet and email activity for the end user. It provides very simple deployment and a stronger interaction with the end users to enable the user awareness, which I will come to its details. What are the advantages for the MSSPs? Complete white labeling support is provided. Not only the front end the users see, even the Outlook plugin that end users use can be white labeled. It can be deployed on any Kubernetes-based platform. It utilizes any cloud platform. It provides the ability to enroll and initiate customers in minutes. And it has full support for self-management and customer tracking. So let's start with products. The first product is DevSite. DevSite will be available from July. Networking is spreading. Attackers are now trying to exploit email communication. And by after COVID-19, that rate increased 667%, by the way. DevSite provides end users to get a feeling if that email is malicious. And they're able to report that malicious email. And once reported, of course, the IT administrators, the security administrators analyze. And if they decide that it is risky, it can be deleted from all other user mailboxes. So what are the modules of DevSite? We have a simulation module so that we send phishing simulation emails to increase the awareness of the end users. It has a training module which enables organizations to train their users. We have the site which performs automatic classification of the suspicious emails and the analyzer for robust inbox security, where we have a plugin in the user's Outlook, which is available, you know, Windows, Mac, mobile, doesn't matter. They can use that tool to analyze the email and report it if they think is malicious. It is deployed centrally through Office 65 and Microsoft Exchange. It is completely GDPR compliant. When the user reports the email, we don't send the body. Only, you know, domains, links, the critical information is sent for analysis. For example, let's say that there's a phishing attack, any domain has been registered, which is not known in any signature-based system. We are able to identify that a new phishing site has been just created. We don't know the source. And we notify the user, look, this is an unknown domain, unknown link, which is not known in the internet. It's not classified. So that we are able to provide them a very solid level of visibility. If the IT administrators decide that the mail is malicious, it can be automatically deleted. And of course, built-in templates are available for simulation attacks and trainings. NetSight is our next solution. Why network access control? I mean, it's basic security. There should not be any uncompliant device in the network. We have extended the NAC to cover the remote workforce as well. So it is very interesting area to discover, which I will briefly explain after, you know, summarizing the DNSSEC technology, how we combine these two technologies to protect our end users, which are connecting remotely from their offices or homes. So what are the important features of NetSight? It is network vendor agnostic. It is very flexible. It is the most advanced agentless solution to do threat analysis in the endpoints. Globally, we are the only company which can do such depth analysis without an agent. because we are a .NET based platform, we're able to use Microsoft's native APIs to really get a very detailed view of the risks in the endpoint. If there are external users in the infrastructure, like contractors and others, we are able to do threat assessments on them. And if they create any malicious activity or threat-related activity, we are able to block them. It is a great enabler for segmentation and discover any component, any device in the network. These are some use cases. An international bank having more than 1,000 remote branches in 4 different countries, where they had requirements for network segmentation, agentless threat discovery, enabler before BYOD, and integration to their SOAR platforms. Again, a university with 60,000 students, where even the students enrolled the system through our platform. So once they come to the network campus, they are enrolled in a very controlled way for accessing the resources of the university. When we are very competitive, when the customer requires an agentless solution, as I said, we are very, very strong in agentless endpoint analysis and threat analytics. When they need to identify and block guests and contractors if they create any malicious activity without doing traffic analysis and looking for a very simple and scalable method to have control over these guests, we are able to do it very well. Threat discovery is important. And the network is heterogeneous, so they require multiple methods for detection and prevention. And the network is mostly Windows-based because we are very, very strong in terms of performance. Why? Windows-to-Windows connections for enumeration is a lot less resource-intensive. Our competitors are Linux-based, and they are much more inefficient in agentless systems. So DNS Site is one of our core technologies. It's a very critical technology. Why? We are because using it in our net site and in our dev site. So what is recursive DNS security that DNS Site provides? Every malicious activity uses DNS to communicate. Why? It must connect to internet, and that starts with the DNS query. Once we are able to intercept these DNS queries by acting as a DNS server, we have a complete visibility of the activity of the user. And if there's anything malicious, like communication to a command and control service, malicious websites, we are able to identify it and block it. It provides a complete visibility for all the internet usage. DNS security is growing like crazy. Why? Because of the ability of easy deployment, and it is very, very scalable. It stops zero-day attacks. It enforces internet usage policies. It enables whitelisting. It blocks DNS tunneling, which is a very, very important and risky method for data exfiltration the malicious software uses. We are extremely strong in identifying DNS tunneling attacks, and of course, users can be on offices or mobile. We protect them everywhere. Again, some use cases: an international hospital, a university, a government. On these customers, we were able to identify malicious traffic to command and control servers. We were able to identify bottlenecks in their DNS servers, why there was a performance issue. And on top of that, in a very recent deployment, again, in an international bank, we have identified malicious traffic which were not identified from their perimeter systems. So it's a very strong platform to make sure that the security perimeter is working strong. Again, when DNS Site is very, very competitive, when an agentless solution is required, when the MSSP requests the platform to be hosted on their premise, when more detailed classification is needed, due to our technology, we are able to identify malicious websites with higher accuracy. And If a site is unknown to us, we classify that in 10 minutes, which our competitors cannot do. And through the platform, we are able to provide additional services like parental control for telcos. And this is a short summary of how we are blending these technologies to secure the remote workforce, even without deploying any and component agents, you know, on these devices. What happens is, when they connect to the VPN to access corporate resources, through the VPN, our DNS site servers are enforced as their DNS server. So they just start using us as their DNS. Once they start using us as their DNS, of course, we are able to track any malicious activity. And if we detect the malicious activity, first we notify the user through SMS or email, look, there is some malicious activity from your device. There might be a problem. Secondly, we block their VPN access. So without deploying any agents, we are able to control the remote workers very easily without any performance issue and without making additional large-scale investments. Why? We are only looking to their DNS traffic. So I will be showing you the product demo now on the tech related to the technology. Then I'll be very, very happy to answer your questions. Let me, I hope now you should be seeing my browser. So when you first log in, you are, of course, greeted with the dashboard. So in the dashboard, you see a summary for all of our applications. DNS site is here, where you see the malicious, or you see all the DNS activity categorized and classified. There is a short summary of the malicious domains accessed, harmful domains, and the new domains that has just been discovered. We see the triage, which the users report for the users report malicious email. We see emails reported, unresolved, and all the activity. You know, who reported them? What were the users? We see the simulation emails sent as a summary. And lastly, the training activity. So in one single dashboard, we are able to visualize all of this. And for the reported emails, if we decide that that mail should be deleted, the user just says, delete this email. And it is all done. It is deleted from all user email boxes if the mail is decided to be malicious. If you access the details of the email, you see the metadata information related to the email. So it's very, very easy to use, very, very easy to deploy because everything is on the cloud. For the MSSPs, it is really a game changer. Let me review the modules, then lastly come to that part. So this is how you visualize the reported emails, and it is very straightforward to configure and customize. There are just some specific tags which enable you to define how the module works, and you're able to customize all front end the end user sees, even for the admin. And to deploy, you just add this URL to the Exchange server or Office 365, and it's just deployed in seconds to all of the users. So it's very easy to deploy and very, very, very easy to configure. Simulation is very straightforward. I mean, this is a very, very simple solution. Again, there is a summary dashboard for it. And initiating a campaign is very easy. You just define a campaign name. Well, let's say, you define the recipients. It's very easy to define the recipients. You choose the template to send. For example, I want to send Dropbox. then this is what they click, what they see when they click on it. And if they somehow progress, that's the training that, that they will use. You initiate the campaign and the users receive the email and you just get the responses. So it's very straightforward. Training is similar. I mean, it's very easy to use. Again, you initiate a campaign. You just give a name. You just choose the course, mail safety, and you choose, you choose the recipient, and the campaign just starts for training. We have a central policy engine, and the real catch is the multi-threaded infrastructure. So an MSSP can create a new customer. Okay. And just invite users just from their emails and they start using the platform immediately. Once it is created, you just switch to that organization and now everything you see, as you see, is for that organization. So the MSSP can deploy their, can enroll their customers just in minutes and can manage them as separate entities. It is very, very flexible and it's very, very easy to deploy. So that's why the simplicity is the key. That's why offering this through an integrated platform is the key. And as I said, for DNS site, which offers much more visibility, you know, you just click on our cloud site and you see the DNS site activity in much more detail, where you can configure it, you can just set deployment settings, and of course you can monitor the activity. So it's very straightforward to use it and utilize it. So this is just a short summary of the dev site platform and DNS site. Let me also show you the end user component. I think it might be quite nice to see that one as well. So let me share my Outlook with you. Yes. Now you should be seeing my Outlook. There's an email. Okay. And for this email, I just want to analyze it and you just see a summary of this email. It says that there are hidden links, so be careful. This is a warning. When it is, the system detects that it is really malicious, it gives a red warning. So you have the summary, you have a history, and you see the domain categories. This email has these domains included and these links inside. So there are many links inside this email. And the user can just report the email if they think is malicious. So it is that easy to use. And the visibility it creates is quite strong. So let's turn back to our browser. Yeah, you are seeing my browser now. The last product to demonstrate very shortly is our next solution. So let's just log into the Mac. I just want to show the visibility that it provides, you know, so that you just get a feeling, and I'll be very happy if you need further details. I'll be very happy to share it. This is the NEC platform. Okay. And we provide a very strong level of visibility. As I said, DNS site is in all of our products. Through our NEC, you're able to visualize the traffic of your end users by just looking to their DNS traffic. So as you see here, we have access by category, access by IP, user, host name, and of course their logs of this access. based on this DNS activity, we are able to create rules saying that if you see Malicious activity, block that device through our NAC, features, through SENAC in the end. The visibility it provides for threat analysis is very strong. From the endpoints, it has seen these threats so far. A new service has been installed. A process created network traffic. A new scheduled task was created. There are unknown scheduled task entries. On three machines, we have the antivirus disabled. So the visibility it provides is really very strong. So, for example, these are very high-risk ones. Antivirus is disabled, and we have an unknown auto-run entry. And where we can see its details. So we have security health SysTray as a component which is available in the auto-run of the end user device, which needs to be, of course, looked at. There is a visibility that we provide where you see all sensitive parts of the operating system to decide if there is something malicious. Auto-run entries, services, processes, listening ports are all visualized, and you just set them, if that's, for example, acceptable, you just add them to a trust list. So once you add them to a trust list, then they are removed. So once you create your trust list, if there's anything that you do not know, you are able to visualize it and see it in just minutes. We are able to provide a very good visibility for the network. Let me search for this user as an example. So I see that this user is logged in on these three switch ports. So there is a very good level of visibility for the network and for the infrastructure. Lastly, let me show the geolocation analysis and then answer your questions. In geolocation analysis, visualize how the processes are creating network traffic. For example, we see that the user used the browser to create a traffic. So I can just filter the traffic which is known to me. So now what stays is, some other processes creating traffic. So we are able to map how traffic is created from processes and visualize that in a map. So that if there's something abnormal, you are able to visualize it immediately. I think this is, all on my side. And I will be very happy to answer your questions.
Those who have any questions, you can use the Q&A chat window to post your questions in there. We'll read them out for you and answer them accordingly.
So the licensing of NetSight. The licensing is based on the number of users or IP addresses. We support both licensing models. And it is subscription. We also have a perpetual model as well. So it's very flexible, supporting both perpetual and subscription. And the licensing can be based on the number of active employees in the organization or active IP addresses. It's all their preferences. And of course, we'll be very happy, to do separate sessions on your interest areas based on your focus and the clarifications that you will need. Bulwark will be very happy to arrange this for us so that we can discuss on more details. Okay, anything else I can answer that you want to know about? Yes, the NAC includes the asset module built-in, and it is completely a virtualized platform. There is no hardware. You just deploy it on VMware or Hyper-V, whatever the preferences. And that's why it's also installed and run just in minutes. I mean, we provide a built-in ready image. Just people download it and start using it. It's very easy to deploy in an infrastructure. So I think.
Yeah, I think, Hikati, I think the questions will probably come at a later stage. There's still some folks wanting for further presentation on the solution, but we will take that offline. So if there's no other questions going forward, I would like to.
One more question.
I think there's one question. Yeah.
Just let me answer that. Can this be created for all devices with MAC address? And if device needs connect, it will be blocked till I add to whitelist. Yes, definitely. You can do that. You can create a whitelist for all. In fact, the system discovers all the devices and brings you all the Macs, and you can just choose it as well. So it's very, very flexible, and it's very easy to operate the system based on the Mac addresses that you choose and prefer, of course. Okay, I think that was the last one. Yeah, thank you, Darpa, for your question.
Okay, then with that, we will end this current session. Thank you, everyone, for your attention and your time. We hope you found the session useful. And if there's any questions at all that you would like to ask us, you can please post it to our email address, where you've got the presentation links. And if there's anything at all, we will certainly come back to you and help you with those answers. So thank you very much, everyone, and have a good day. Thank you.